This video is sponsored by Avail. With the driver demand at an all-time high, now is the time for drivers to come together and fight for fair conditions, more control, better rates, and more freedom. This can be done through the Avail app. Avail wants to get rid of agencies so that drivers can get better wages, have control of where they work, and choose their own work pattern. Want to know more? Download the Avail app today. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to my channel. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. Hopefully everyone is doing all right. Today is Monday. Monday morning, start of the week. We've got a, I wouldn't say a busy day, but we've got a relatively long drive today. We've got to go to Tetbury. We're on our way there now this morning. It's probably worth mentioning it's about 6:30 in the morning so far. We are currently on our way to Tetbury to go get loaded. We've got two drops to do today. One is in Chester and one is in Penrith, which, as far as I'm concerned, is just south of Carlisle. So it's a bit of a trip up there, I believe. Unless I'm thinking of completely different areas, which wouldn't surprise me. but yeah, that's where we go. I think Chester's just south of Liverpool, I believe, and Penrith is just south of Carlisle. So we're going to be on the top of English borders later on today, so it should be a night out. I'd be very surprised if I was back. I won't be back tonight. but we need to go get loaded first, so that's what we're going to do now. I'm secretly hoping it's just pallets, because that's a lot easier than bulk bags. but we'll have to wait and see. We're on our way there now. We're going to be there in about 8 minutes, but they don't open straight away, so I'm hoping I could be sort of like first in line. That's the plan, but it don't always go to plan, so. Yes. Let's make our way there and see you in a bit. Okay, good news, we are first. Red light, so we can't go anywhere. No, we're first in line, so that's good. We're gonna grab our paperwork now. There's some bird yapping away down there. And over there. Birds are waking up. Yeah, so we're gonna go grab our paperwork now and get the postcodes for where we're going and put it in the sack house. Get the destinations ready to go. Go from there, really. Go get paperwork. Left my phone in the truck. Phone's got the reference number on it. We got it. Here we go. Right, let's try again. Let's go get our paperwork. Okay, situation update. Got paperwork. There was a little bit of confusion because I can only find the paperwork for Chester. I couldn't find any paperwork for Penrith. But it turns out that I'm not technically delivering. Well, I am delivering, but it's not on paperwork. I don't know. bulk bags or something. That's what we're doing. So I'm just going to sit tight now for someone to turn up. Then I've got to let them know about the Penrith drop. Hopefully they know what it is. They can put the Penrith stuff on first. Apparently it's going to Jenkinson's in Penrith, so head up there. Okay, we are currently now getting loaded. We've got like plastic stuff on, don't know if you can quite see there. Like plastic rolls or something, I'm not quite sure what it is. But I don't know how much exactly is going on. I think there's another maybe three or four more rows backwards to go yet. But yeah, that's got to go on. Then the bulk bags have got to go on. And then we can make our way to Chester. So, let's get loaded.
Okay, we are now loaded and we are heading towards Chester now. We've just left Tetbury. We got sort of like half a load of pallets, double stacked, and which are ratchet strapped. And then we got sort of half a load of bulk bags, which is, they're filled with bark. And so I've just used internals on them because they're very light. So yeah, we're heading to Chester now. It's just about to turn 9 a.m. and it's a good 3 hour and 20 minute drive there. So obviously we're going to be there sort of around about 20 past 12, maybe half past 12. I'm sure we'll get stuck in traffic somewhere on the way. Might even stop to get some food or drink as well for the rest of the day. It is a long drive from, well, to there, and then obviously then up to Penrith as well. So we are loaded. I did do a segment just now when I was actually at Tetbury saying I was loaded, but I think the SD card failed, so hopefully this works. Right, let's get going. I shall see you in a few hours. Okay, you join me about a mile and a half away from where we need to be. There's some little villages we're having to go through here. I can't go until you go. Thank you. Yeah, we've just been going through some villages. One of the roads is closed that we just had to take. There was a diversion, so we followed that. And we're just going through a load of villages now. Red, a lot of lanes. Church lane, red lane, some other lane we were on. Loads of lanes. But they're not too bad. There's you can get two lorries past as long as you go past each other slowly anyway, you could. But we've had nothing come back this way yet. So we're just gonna carry on. I do wonder if it's easier going out the other way. Looks to be a main road not too far away. Might be slightly longer, but easier, bigger roads. We'll see. Like I said, I've got to go Penrith from here. I'll put that into the sat nav before I leave and I'll see what way we got to go. TB Building Supplies, is that building over there? Cool. Right, we've got an eye on them. Well, we want to turn right here. Car's letting me through. Lovely jubbly. Right, where do we want to go in here? Merchants, concrete plant. Merchants is to the left. There's a red traffic light system. Do I stop here? I think I'll go in here. Yeah. There's another lorry in here, look. I'll just, I think I'm just gonna park up here for a sec. Go see someone. Might be in a completely wrong place. We shall see. Right, see you in a bit. By hand. What I'm doing, because they were laid down three abreast, you can obviously do one row, you can do the other row, but you can't do the row in the middle. So you sit that side and just now move the ones in the middle over.
So yeah, just taking these 25 bags off now. It's not actually taking too long, so shouldn't be here much longer. Happy days. Yeah, we're more than halfway through now, so it's all good. Middle row's gone, this row's nearly gone, one more bag to go. And then I'll close this curtain up and then we can operate from the ground safely for the rest of it. Happy days. Right. We're tipped. Happy days. As things stand, we're on well over 3.5 hours driving. So we've only got less than an hour left of drive time before we need a break. And I put it in the sat nav, we're just under 3 hours away from where we need to be. So we need to have a break before we get there to Penrith to do my second delivery. So we need to stop somewhere on the way. The bloke here has been very kind. He said I can have a break right where I am. So just put it on break. We're gonna have a 45 minute break here and happy days. Then we can just crack straight on to Penrith. So that's good. Good forklifter, very quick. Happy with that.
Oh,
right. Let's put my glasses on because I'm starting to itch my eye. Right, see you in a bit.
When we were younger, we used to sit on the grass. Among the flowers, we just let the days pass by. People would tell us to get a grip of ourselves and get a job. We didn't care what we were told, 'cause when we were younger, we used to sit on the grass and go, damn, I don't wanna grow old. I wish I could turn back time. Mm-mm. Stay up all night singing songs on the terrace. We didn't mind sitting out in the cold. It was impossible to make us embarrassed. We were free.
Okie dokie, you join me about 2.5 hours later. It's and we're still like really far away from where we need to be. The M6, there's been an accident up sort of near Preston Way, I think it was. And then just north of Preston as well, like Lancaster, I want to say. There's a couple of accidents. The M6 is actually shut at one point. We've resorted to going a different way, which is the way we're on now. We're currently on the A682, which will take us to the A65. We want to go left here. But it's very much countryside. I've had the dash cam running time lapse for like couple of hours, I think. So you might have seen it all already. Or I might include it after this. I'm not sure yet what I've done editing-wise. But yes, there's a lot of country lanes, a lot of up and down hills. The sun is very quickly going down right now as well. Time currently is 5 to 4. Half four? Hey Siri, what time does the sun set?
Today. 16:34,
so just after 4:30. Yeah, it's going to be well and truly dark when we get there. We've got to follow this road for a bit more. We will be joining back onto the M6 just after where it's been shut. So let's get crack-a-lacking. See you in a bit. When they found out we ran from home just to scare them, we were free when we were 17.
Seventeen. were younger, we used to sit on the grass and go, damn, I don't wanna grow old. Stay up all night singing songs on the terrace. We didn't mind sitting out in the cold. It wasn't possible to make us embarrassed. We were free. Do you remember stealing smokes from your parents? Sometimes we got a bit out of control. When they found out we ran from home just to scare them, we were free. When we were 17. When we were 17.
If you're looking to get into the HTV industry, or you're already in the industry but want to refine your existing skills, I highly recommend that you purchase the Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. There is a link in the description down below. This thing is absolutely ram-packed with information. Anything and everything you need to know regarding HTV is in this book. Go and buy it. Link is in the description down below.
Right. Probably can't see me very well. I could turn the interior light on a little bit, actually, just for now. Right, we're 3 minutes away, just over a mile away now from where we need to be. We've done just under 4 hours driving to get here, which is not great. It means we will need to have a break on site if we can, because I haven't seen any available lay-bys on the way out of here, unless I just park up on the road. It'd be quiet. I could park up on the road and have a quick 45-minute break if I needed to, just on the road somewhere here on a wide area, hazards on. You're allowed to do that. There's no line set saying you can't stop. So, we're nearly here. Just 2 minutes away now. I believe I said that Google said they close at 5. They actually close at 6, according to Google. But my boss did say they're open 24/7. So, hopefully we can get tipped. You'll protrude into the road a little bit. Let's go around you. I'm a maintenance van. So yeah, we're going to get tipped, and then I'm hoping that I can get a break in somewhere and then make my way down towards York. That's the plan. Park somewhere on an A road. I'm probably just going to park up, not straight away, but I won't be driving too long before I park up, because it's, like I said, it's gone 5 o'clock now, so lay-bys will be getting busy. I don't like the dark nights. Don't like the dark nights at all. In fact, now the street light's gone, gonna have to turn the interior light off. So yeah, we're only a minute away. I don't want to film too much in their yard, because it's a Jenkinson's yard, and I know that Jenkinson's drivers aren't allowed to vlog, so I won't be filming too much in the yard, but I'll see what I can get. Right, we're just here now. I'll see you on the other side once we're tipped, or maybe even getting tipped. See you in a bit. Right, we're tipped. Oh my god, that was quick. Hang on. Oops, I don't need this on. So we haven't been here long at all. We've been here just over half an hour, and 15 minutes of that was me getting a break in, and the other 15 minutes was getting tipped. Very, very quick. Lovely jubbly. Beacons off. Drive forward. I'm gonna have to turn the lights off, I'm afraid. Doesn't matter, because this is going to be the end of the video. So thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. Yeah, it does mean a lot. Before I go, I just want to find out why the sat nav's telling me to go right and not left. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, we'll go right. So before I do go, we've got 45 minutes left of drive time. Do you know what? Actually, I'm not going to go yet. I'll wait until I'm parked up, and I will say bye to you properly. But we've got 45 minutes of drive time left before we need to have another half an hour break. And if we have a half an hour break, we can then drive for another sort of hour and 15 minutes. We've got 2 hours and 10 minutes left total that we can have for tonight. But we do need a half an hour break in there somewhere as well, if we do go over 45 minutes. So we're going to carry on. There's, well, on the A6 at the moment, we're going to be heading on to the A46, I think it said, or something like that, 66, something like that. We're going to go down those A roads. It takes you straight to the A1. Might stop somewhere there in a lay-by on the A road, if there is one. And we'll certainly have a break at least, but we'll see if I want to go any further than that or not tonight. Because Yeah, I might actually just park up in 45 minutes. That way I've not used a 10-hour drive. Do you know what I mean? But we will see. I'll say bye to you in a second when we actually get there. I'll let you know where I am with the lights on so you can see me. That could be good or bad. Right, see you in a bit. Right, 6 o'clock. I've decided to pull over for break. I'm going to have half an hour break here. Yeah, we're on break. Have a 30-minute break. Hey Siri, set a timer for 30 minutes. Okay, don't do it then. Hey Siri, set a timer for 30 minutes.
30 minutes, starting now.
Ooh. Yep, don't want to be parking here tonight. I don't mind parking on lay-bys, but not lay-bys like this, where it's like right next to the road. Because every time a truck goes past, it just rocked. Not ideal. It would be nice if all lay-bys in the UK were the wide lay-bys, where you had like a an island in the middle, and you sort of you got enough room for a truck to go past you, between you and the main road. That's the nice lay-bys. But yeah, we're going to stop here for half an hour. Got a little fluff on me. Stop here for half an hour, and then we've resumed driving. I want to get closer, because we're still like a good 2 hours away for tomorrow, and I want to get there for like 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock the absolute latest. So that means starting at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. I think actually I'm going to be starting that sort of time regardless. Well, no. See, I'm getting confused now. If I drive 2 hours further tonight, I can start 2 hours later tomorrow morning, if that makes sense. So I'd rather do as much as I can today, even if it means going into a 10-hour drive. So I'm just going to do some more calculations on how much drive time I got, because the clock will reset, and then I know that I've got to be parked up before it reaches a certain time. So I'm just going to do that. Right, so I'm on 8 hours and 14 minutes already. Right, so I've done a printout. I can do 1 hour and 46 minutes of driving from here, maximum. That would be on a 10-hour drive. So that's what I can't go over from here. I do have a destination in place. It's sort of in York. I think it was the A46. So I'm going to go down the A1. Yeah, A1M, come off, I'm going to bear left, go down, A59, and then there's a couple of lay-bys down there. I'm going to try and get in one of the big ones on the other side of the road so I can sort of spin round and then face back the other way to come back to the A1M again. That's the plan. But yeah, we're going to stop here for half an hour first, and then we're going to do the hour or so drive down to York. Hopefully there's a space. We should be there for about 8 o'clock. Oh, that's the other thing. I can work until 9:15. So should be fine for working time. That's the plan. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, so I've made the executive decision. I think I'm going to stop. I know you can't see me right now, but there is apparently a lay-by in half a mile's time. As long as it's a wide one, I think I'm just going to stop there for tonight. I'm on the A66, which I've been down before in the daylight, and it's lovely round here. Obviously, you can't see much at the moment. It's dark. Okay, there's another parking symbol up here. Nothing behind me, I'm just gonna start slowing down a little bit. Was that half a mile? Yeah. Parking in half a mile. Let's see what this one is like. Okay, there's the parking sign. I see a truck there. Is it a big one? Oh, it looks like a big one. Is there room? Not sure if there's room. Oh, there is room. There is room. Oh, wicked. Right, so I'm just gonna go up the curb a second so I can get nice and straight. Go up to this lorry here, lovely TK Maxx truck. Don't want to get too close because I want to be able to get out and again in the morning.
Right, so let me just turn the light on a sec. Right. Ooh. I want to see what it's like when a truck goes past. There's one coming now. Yeah, there's a bit of shake, but there's not much. All right, cool. I think I'm going to park here for the night. So we're an hour and a half away from the destination tomorrow. 1 hour and a half, which is good. Time now is a little bit after 7 o'clock. So 9 hours off. We'll probably start again 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. Probably start again about 4:30. Might make it 5 o'clock, actually. Yeah, I'll make it 5 o'clock. Wake up at 5. Do my checks, aim to leave sort of like 5:15, and then it's an hour and a half there, so 6:45, yeah, should be there for about 6:45, yeah, in which case I might as well stay for 7 o'clock, just in case they're not open. Right, so we're parked up now. What I need to do is do my end of day paperwork and checks. I do this every time. I never turn the engine off straight away, because let it cool down a little bit before you turn it off. That's what I've always been advised. I'm just going to fill in a little bit of paperwork. Put down the mileage we finish at. And then we put it down ready for tomorrow. Same details. Right, now we got to go do some end-of-day checks. Well, we haven't got to, but I like to. I've said before, I always do checks now, before I clock off, because if there is any issues, I could potentially fix it tonight, before I clock off, rather than leave it until the morning, when it could be an issue. Or, say I got a tyre which is on its way out, or whatever. I'll turn the engine off now. Say I got a tyre on its way out, I can maybe get someone out now and fix it tonight, before I clock off. So yeah, we do leave our lights on outside. We're gonna go do our checks. I'll bring you with me. Let's go for a ride. Okay, so here we are, side of the A66, torch in hand. Just checking the truck over, make sure it's all okay. So my lights are still on. See, that's another thing, if one of the bulbs are out, I could change it tonight before I clock off, rather than first thing in the morning. I'd rather do it tonight. So we're just gonna go around, check everything's all right. Quick visual checks. Airlines are all okay. Check the old tyres, tyrenios. Lights on the back of the truck. Needs to clean this truck. All the lights are on, that's good. Side lights are working. It's a really bright torch, isn't it? This is a torch from Olight in my hand. Very small, but very powerful. And they haven't paid me to say that. Another truck there going past. It's a very dark road, look. You can literally see nothing until I shine a torch. And even then, you can't see much. Right, number plate is on. All the lights are on. Oh. While I'm here, I'll open the door. Make sure there's nothing coming. Open it up. I've said before why I always open my door. Even if I got a load on, I will open the door. If someone wants to take what's inside, you crack on. You don't need to slash the curtains, because the door is open. If you're going to take it, just take it. That's the way I see it anyway. Taking a load is that's why companies have insurance. Do you know what I mean? ripping a curtain takes the haulier, takes the truck, the trailer off the road until it's fixed, which costs a lot more time and money. So I always personally just keep the back door open. If someone wants to have a little peek in, they can. Obviously I'm empty, so they're just idiots if they rip the curtain still. They're just doing it for fun then. Anyway, we'll carry on looking down this side, checking everything, making sure it's all okay. The suspension does actually look a little bit low there. Just going to make sure the suspension is levelled on the back. Should be. Yep. Yeah. It's the same this side. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe it's just because of the angle I was at. So yeah, this is what I'm saying. So I'm parked here. I've got a road next to me. Well, it's not a road, but it's an area that trucks can pass or whatever. And then there's the main road over here. So, happy days. Final checks. Put that on as best I can. Yeah, we're looking good. We are looking good. So yeah, best I can tell, everything is all okay with the truck. So we're gonna go inside now. We're gonna clock off, turn the lights off, close the curtains, go to sleep. We'll wake up in the morning, we'll do it all again. Anyway, thanks for watching, do appreciate it. Been a nice little trip up to Penrith. A bit wet sometimes, but fortunately when it come to it and I had to tip, it was not raining, so very grateful for that. Very grateful. Anyway, thanks for watching. Till next time, drive safe, stay safe. I will see you soon. Bye-bye.